So much has changed when it comes to technology. It's crazy to think that just 20 years ago, I was sucking my thumb while playing Frogger on a PS1. Yet here I am with an artificial body capable of doing whatever I please. Look at me, Mom! I'm a freaking cat girl! I feel like we often forget how far we've come and what all is possible. Virtual reality has become one of my favorite pastimes, with VRChat being one of my favorite places to go. The social aspect of the VR world not only allows you to bridge the gap between you and others, it also allows you to experience things normally not possible. However, like all social structures created by mankind, we often create things in our image, which means that certain things and, vices do occur in this world. Yeah, there's a lot that happens behind closed doors, if you catch my drift. And that's exactly what I'm here to document. Also, there's going to be two interviews being done today, so that's going to be interesting. So, how's it going, you beautiful sons of guns? My name's the Dapper Saint, and today we'll take a look at the unspoken world of ERP. Before going any further, I think it's worth touching on the fact that we live in a society. Please refrain from any dated jokes. In the real world, there are social norms and rules implemented to reinforce appropriate behaviors while also discouraging anything deemed inappropriate. Well, no shit. But why is that important? It's important because, as stated previously, we create things in our own image, which means that VRChat is no different. As VRChat grows, so does a necessity for innovation and changes, but also comes different security systems, new guidelines, etc. It's an endless cycle that I've coined the revolution of expression, albeit a little bit different than how normal societies grow. But basically what I'm trying to get to without getting too sidetracked is the fact that there are obvious do's and don'ts as there are in a normal society. And I think that's just a good thing to keep in mind if we are to fully understand why ERP is a thing and why it occurs. But if there's three things that are always inevitable, it's death, taxes, and the big horny. ERP, standing for erotic roleplay, is any sort of RP that involves a sexual element, be it full-on sex or aggressive hand-hugging. Oh, my favorite. Now, you might be wondering, how and why does that even work? Well, there are typically two answers. The first one is the usage of devices made for long-distance relationships. Without going too much into detail, these devices were made to be able to, enjoy the presence, so to speak, of your partner, which happens to work really well in the world of virtual reality. The second one, and the more interesting one, is the concept of phantom touch. Phantom touch is the idea that you're able to almost feel something without that being, well, possible. This is a bit of a mixed bag for many people, as some people believe it's a thing while others think it's completely made up. You don't have to do ERP to feel phantom touch, however, as I myself have had a situation where I felt like I had phantom touch. I mean, what phantom touch really is just information overload to your brain, and it's just kind of like filling the gaps, you know? Which makes a lot of sense. Virtual reality is a lot more detailed than people think. For instance, there's a thing called dynamic bones, which makes it so that hair, articles of clothing, and other things have physics. Oh yeah, and these physics can typically be interacted with. I don't think I need to explain this any further. Oh, and don't get me even started on how high quality these avatars are getting. Models dedicated to such acts are in fact made, which means that they get every single part done in gold. I'm talking thick thighs, opis, and probably a surprise. And couple that with the fact that headset resolutions and field of views are getting better and better, and bam, the only thing you're missing is the physical aspect. Outside of the how and more into the why, there's a lot of reasoning in this area as well. People have urges sometimes, and what better way to fulfill those urges than online? Plus, you can be whoever you want to be, which means that the possibilities with your waifu or husbando are quite literally endless. And I think one of the biggest selling points is the fact that it's just kind of like normalized. You know that whole part at the beginning when I talked about behind closed doors and stuff? Well, here you go. Of course, you can't just do stuff willy-nilly, but there are places, like in the real world, that not only allow these acts, but even accommodate them. After all, the rules say no explicit content in public areas. Nobody said anything about private. A great example of that is where I am right now. The vast majority of this video was recorded in a place called Just Be Club. This place not only has locations to hang out with friends and play pool, but also has several penthouses made for whatever you want. This place has a ton of features and it's super interactive. However, you know how I said some places accommodate such things? Well, let's look at some of the features here penthouse-wise. First off, there's a very nice looking intercom system and it lets you see who's at the door. The world is highly interactive and apparently you can even touch buttons with your feet because you know, don't forget that full body tracking is a thing. Well, let's see what sells. Cool mirror system, really good lighting, and a seeking company button. Huh. Okay, so I hope I've given you a basic idea of exactly what ERP is, because we're about to get into the big part of this video, which are the interviews! What am I pointing at? Kind of looking at myself like, should I stay perched like this? How do you feel about this? Am I menacing enough? Me and my tiny body?
You got a T pose for me.
Yeah.
Now flap your arms.
Ka-ka, ka-ka.
So, I guess the best place to start is by just introducing yourself.
Hi, my name's Nick-Nack. I've played VRChat for about a year now.
Hey, so I'm Kaoura. I've been playing VRChat since about 2017.
So one of the things I do want to ask first and foremost is, what exactly, how would you define ERP? Like, what is ERP to you?
It's essentially virtual sex. I mean, there's not a lot of differences other than, like, the actual physical contact. And even then, you know, some people have such strong phantom sense that, I mean...
Do you get a lot of phantom touch, actually?
When I first started playing, I didn't really understand it, and I kind of thought it was kind of bullshit. I'd say I started off in half body. The more I started playing, you know, people would come up to you and, like, head pat you or, like, whoop you on the nose and stuff. And that started to, like, you know, feel strange, because it's not that you feel touch, it's that you feel the anticipation of touch, right? And I think that's more of where it comes from. And I mean, the longer I played and I got full body, you know, you start to see your legs move around and stuff. Your brain kind of starts to trick you a little bit.
As you said, everyone is a little different with how their phantom touch is. So for me personally, I have phantom touch in three different spots. I have it on the tummy, under the chin, and weirdly on the ears that I don't even have. The ears are honestly probably my, like, the weirdest thing, because, like, I don't have, you know, animal ears, obviously. Even though they're not there, like, if someone, like, touches them, I can see them move. It, like, tingles my brain. It, like, it scratches my brain in a really weird way. It's kind of like how ASMR is, like, the first time you hear it, and your brain is like, oh, what is this? You know, it's very similar to that feeling.
All right, fantastic, fantastic. But one thing I am curious about is, what got you into ERP, and how long have you been doing that?
Back in the earlier days of VRChat, it was known that people did sexual stuff, so I figured, you know, I'd try it out myself, right? Because every guy is kind of horny, so, you know.
I use essentially ERP now as, I guess, a vice for when I feel that way and I want to be that way. It's not something that really hurts anyone on here, because kind of everyone's like that on here. And I mean, don't get me wrong, people do catch feels. I'm guilty of that, but you just try not to.
So back then there was this world called Void Club, and it was a known world for, like, just partying, things like that. Originally it was just a dance world, and then eventually people started to kind of use it more as a, like, an underground sex club kind of. It was one of the first worlds to have private rooms where you could, like, go in a room and lock the door, and so people would go there and meet up with strangers, and then, you know, have, like, a little one night stand kind of deal with them.
Really cool. I didn't know about that whole, like, a club thing. So you've been at this for quite some time. I bet you got a hell of a body count, huh?
Yeah. 226, about.
Wait, yeah. Can you say that again, please?
ERP'd with 226 different people as of right now.
Wow. Okay, fair enough.
Yeah, I probably have some kind of VR or something.
How does consent exactly work when it comes to, like, virtual reality? Do you think that there's, like, a lot of good systems when it comes to the world of VR chat that kind of maximize such a thing? Or do you think there's still some, like, problems that do occur?
There are underage people in this game,
mm-hmm.
right, that will pretend to be of age, especially if they're mute. Right, because, like, I've got two rules that I follow religiously in VRChat. The number one is everyone's a guy until proven otherwise. Not that it's a problem. I'm just saying everyone's a guy until proven otherwise. Two is never trust mutes. I'm sorry, I can't really verify you if you're a mute. Right, at least if I'm talking to someone, like, I can, you know, listen to their voice or their maturity level. But at the end of the day, like. You got to be careful. You need to really be careful who you ERP with.
One thing I will say about VRChat, one thing I find interesting about it, is the fact that it's kind of a way of finding and learning more about yourself and your own identity. Do you think that, like, the world of ERP does in fact affect people when it comes to their possibilities of what they are interested in stuff? Maybe breaking down those boundaries they previously wouldn't think of.
So, like I said, when I first started playing this game, I used it as an escape. I was, like, 100% sure, like, I am a straight fucking male. I remember I had made a friend, and we're playing this question game, and the question came up, would you ever ERP with someone of the same sex? And I thought about it for a minute, And then I looked at my friend. I looked at him and I was like, you know, if it was with him, yeah, maybe. And, you know, he got all flustered. And I didn't really think much about it at the time because I was just like, oh, you know, whatever. It's a fucking question. And then I was at work the next day and I was like really thinking about it. And I was like, fuck. Okay. This might be like something new. The more I thought about it, the more I wanted to explore it. And I mean, yeah, I know it's on VRChat, it's virtual. At the time, I was just like, oh, it's just him. Like, there's gonna be no one else. Like, you know, I just for some reason I'm really attracted to him. And then I met someone else, and I was like, oh my god. it was a quite slow roll, to be honest.
Yeah, it's a pretty good question, actually. VRChat overall has definitely made a huge impact on me as a person in terms of like learning about myself. So before VRChat, I was more of kind of like a shy, standoffish guy. You know, I didn't want to be the center of attention. In terms of things like sexuality and stuff like that, when I first started the game, like everyone, you just think that you're pretty much straight. You know, you're like 99% straight. And then as you play the game, you kind of start to see people for who they are and not for their looks.
That was another thing too, is that like it changed my mental perspective, I guess, as well, about the trans community, because I didn't understand trans people at all. And you know, you see social media and you see the worst of it, right? I found that a lot of trans people on VRChat are really friendly. I've spoken with a lot of them about it, and I got to learn a lot more about it and really gain a lot of respect for it. I think looking back, I was just really ignorant on the topic, and VRChat helped me, you know, open my eyes up to, you know, a new community, I guess.
Honestly, that's actually really cool. I never thought about that aspect of it, to be perfectly honest. But yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, thank you so much for your time. Do you want to add anything else before we're done here?
I think everyone should try VR one day, and don't think that it's still this new technology that is something that is still experimental or expensive. And yes, it can be expensive, but it is absolutely worth it, even if it's to not ERP.
ERP is originally when it first became kind of popular, or even like a thing in general, it was very seen as taboo, like back in 2018. I feel like a lot of people have this misconception of ERP, or they think it's gross. And as someone who does it a lot, you know, I want to say it's not gross, right? It's just two consenting adults that are like, hey, you want to whack off together? That's pretty much it.
When originally sitting down for these interviews, I hadn't anticipated it to go like this. I think one of the main things that popped out to me was disconnection between oneself and their body. Of course, such a thing is being mimicked artificially, and the sensations are still possible, but it seems like the fluency of one's body in VR allows for certain boundaries to be pushed that otherwise wouldn't, not only allowing for a better understanding of yourself, but others as well. Also, Kaoura is a fellow YouTuber, so go check them down in the link below. And Nick Nack wanted me to plug one of his friends, so that's down there as well. Once again, thank you two so much for everything. This video couldn't have been done without you. We went over a lot in this video, and quite frankly, I am physically and mentally exhausted, so I think I'm gonna end it there. But I would love to hear what you guys think down in the comments, whether it be about the video or the world of ERP. Also, I just want to say thank you everybody for your patience. I needed that break on my throat, and it's a good thing that I did that. But hey, if you're new and you were at the end of this video, you're probably a degenerate, so why not subscribe? Oh, and in other news, I finally decided to make a Patreon. So maybe if you want to go support my silly antics and these weird videos, well, there you go. Not gonna lie, the Patreon's kind of just there so I can use that money towards buying more games and props for videos, so yeah. But honestly, at the end of the day, all I can ask is that you have a wonderful night tonight, and as always, stay dapper.